we can't not speak to you about the reason that we're actually speaking, if you know what I mean. So like, you've put together this amazing video about street surfers and talking about pollution and stuff like that. Like, but it's honestly, like, for me, being South African especially, like, it brought not only like joy and like happiness to me, but also like tears, you know, like there's this sort of real kind of contradiction, I guess, of it in a great way. Can you maybe just tell us like how that came about, you know, doing that video?
Thanks, man. Yeah, like so many people have said that they brought tears to their eyes, and I don't think we ever expected it to go so viral, you know. And I just want to say a big shout out to Corona, because you know Corona is a massive global brand, and this is, they paid for the video, like this is their video, you know, like, and for them to not have branded that like that at all, really, and like to really believe in getting rid of single-use plastic. And you know, I've been working with them a lot. Their beers no longer come in those plastic things, like they come in a cardboard box, and like their whole office is plastic free. And to see a huge corporate brand like that, like really like live up to what they're saying, I think it's amazing. And those are the kind of people that can make a difference, you know, like if Coca-Cola suddenly like, we're not going to use plastic bottles anymore, boom, that's it, no more plastic. That's you know what I mean? That could change the world tomorrow. So yeah, big shout out to Corona. And then also iForce, the production company that I've been working with, who put the film together. They did an amazing job on the video, I think. We shot that film 3 times before with another company. But the street surfers that we used then, we couldn't find them again. Because we got them cell phones, but I think they either had them stolen or they got lost, and we never found the guys again. And I mean, how do you find? And then it's hard to find people. You know, we went to Johannesburg, and it's like, gonna go find some guy in Johannesburg with no ID and no cell phone. Good luck. Good luck with that.
Yeah.
Big city. And I mean, the idea basically came around with Corona and their agency, because they were trying to look at tying people who don't live near the ocean in Johannesburg and don't really have a connection to the ocean with the ocean, and why they should try and protect it, you know. And that's kind of how the whole thing came about. And yeah, man, those two guys, the making the film was when those two guys came to Cape Town, bro, I was also in tears there, like Mokete and Tabu there. They'd never had a shower before, bro. So like, we got them at Airbnb in Camps Bay, and I had to show Tabo like how the shower worked, because they don't have anyone.
No ways, bud.
Yeah, it was deep, eh?
Wow.
So I mean, it's 2019. I had to show him that, dude, like turn the thing and the water comes out. It was just,
yes, bud.
Yeah, like we, no one listening to this has ever in their entire lives got anything to complain about, because those guys' life in reality is so far from anything that we've ever experienced. Like going there was just so mind-blowing to me. Especially going to his little house, little shack. They have no running water, no toilet, so they have like poo in a bucket, obviously, in their little thing, and then they throw the bucket out and rinse it out, and they collect water. And there's like just dirt floors, and they live in the place is like a garbage dump, literally, because they separate the plastic there. But there's like this amazing sense of community there, you know? Like, they see in the video, the guys, when we got there, the guys were making food, and they're like, oh, you want food? Like, imagine going, if I went down the street and asked someone for food, they'd like chase me away.
Yeah.
There's this incredible sense of community, and yeah, it was, a lot of people ask me what now for those guys, and I don't know what the answer is. I don't know, you know, I don't know what we can do. There's 100,000 people in that community. Like, if anything, if that video just raised awareness about those guys and people, you know, from that, give them some respect, that would be insane. But yeah.
Yes, man.
I know, it's crazy.
This is such a beautiful film, bud, seriously. And, yeah, man, like, yes, you said, like, even the stuff, well, there's stuff there that we didn't see, you know, which you just spoke on, like, you know, them never having a shower before.
I had to show him, he'd never been into a shopping center. So I was like, when we were in Joburg still, I was like, look, Yerkes are the biggest legends I've ever met. And I was like, I'm going to buy you whatever you want. Like, let's go to the shop right now. So I took them to Mr. Price. And I was like, you just pay. You buy whatever clothes you want. I'll pay for it. And they'd never been into a shopping center before. They'd never been into a Lyft. The guys at the shop and Mr. Price were like we can't. Like, the security was like, sorry, like, we can't really let these guys into the shop. And I'm like, what do you mean? And like, I mean, and I get it. The guys, they were like street people, you know, like, and it's like quite a fancy mall. And I was just like, really, just buy whatever you want. Like, I, you know, just whatever it's cost me is nothing compared to, you know, like their experience. And they walked out of there with like the biggest smiles on their face. And they had like these shoes and clothes. And just all those new experiences for them. Like when the lift came up, they'd never been a lift, and it opened up and we were in like, you know, in those malls, you like come in into the shop.
Yeah.
And open up like in a women's section in Woolworths. And it was just like, they were like, they'd never seen so much just stuff in their whole life. Like all these things and mannequins. And it was all just like things they'd never seen before, you know? They were just like eyes like this. And I was, yeah, it was the whole thing was just, it was a complete trip, eh? And like, yeah, just, it was crazy, eh?
Yes, absolutely. But it's just, it's so, the contrast of how, is so stark of how much excess there is and stuff in our lives. When you see it, when I hear you speaking like that, I just think, yeah, like if you picture that scene, there's just so much stuff everywhere, and you think, what is it really all?
I know. What is just stuff? It's just crazy. Things, you know. All those guys had with the clothes on their back, and maybe one or two other things at home, and it's like they were like, what do you do with all this stuff? Like, what do people do with it? You know, like.
Yeah.
Another funny story is like, I was like, oh, we're there, and I was like, hey, we're gonna go like have an epic meal, like we just get pizza, like we're just, like buy the boys whatever they want, and they're like, and then we got like a super like healthy kind of pizza, and I checked the top of my kids like trying to eat it, they're like trying their hardest, and they're like, man, this is disgusting, and they're like,
no ways.
They're like, you can imagine, like these guys are. Don't have much. You would think they would be so stoked, and they're like this. They're like, no, we don't like this. This is terrible. You know, they just wanted pup and chicken, and like, or like, carb and like a meat. They didn't want this food that we were eating. I find that so interesting. You know,
this processed rubbish. Yeah.
No, but I mean, what they eat is even worse. It's just processed carb. It's just white carb. It's the same, but they're just like the. I don't know. Their diets are terrible, and I think it's also a lot of why they're in this, like, you know, it keeps you in that situation, just eating that way, like no vegetables, just like meat and divorce. And I thought it was so funny. We took them to this fancy restaurant. They're like, nah, we want KFC.
Good for them, man. Yes, bud. It's such a beautiful story, man. Yes. Thanks so much we got to thank people like you for just doing stuff like that, because it just inspires, you know, innumerable people. It really is that inspiring, and I think everyone that watches that, whether you're South African or not, will get a tear in their eye, because you can relate to the ocean, or you can relate to, you know, there's so many things one can relate in that video, and it's super powerful, man. So,
and it's real. It's not like I'm not trying to like you know what I mean, those guys aren't trying to pretend to be something that they're not. It's just that's how their life is, you know. And that's those things that you saw, like that was the first time they'd ever seen the ocean in their life. Like they'd never seen the ocean. They never left where they were. Like, can you? I mean, you can't fake that.
No,
you're right, bud.
The whole thing was just like, yeah, it was insane.
Crazy, yes, bud.
So yeah, but waking at dawn, packing the gear, September tour, and up in the air. Stop at the toll, digging for change, snowy Cape Fold mountain range. Gotta be quick, so...